Hello friends, so hope you enjoy my last video which was mainly speaking on Cisco DNAC service component like Cisco APKI or Cisco NDP and Cisco ISE with their key roles and responsibility in the DNAC architecture. So in this particular video I will be taking you as a walkthrough for Cisco SDA dashboard or DNAC dashboard, to be very honest, it's not SDA, and with an configuration how to configure a network hierarchy and what is the benefit for that, along with an integration of Cisco ISE, which will be like them. It's a short video and to give you a glimpse of how DNAC integration and configuration happens. More videos on other topics are in pipeline, so stay tuned. Okay, so rather wasting time, let's jump on to the Cisco DNAC dashboard. So if you see, this particular dashboard is of Cisco DNAC Center. So you have three major pillars like design, policy, and provisioning, everything, along with some tools, in-house tools of auto discovery, device inventory, topology, and image management. So in this video, we will be shortening first. So we will go with the design tab. So under the design tab, you see a network hierarchy. I'm just going to showcase you how to create a network. So under this thing, network hierarchy, you will create an area. So this will be more of an how to add a country or something like that. So once I added the country, I want to be more specific. So I'll add under the country what location I'm saying. So let us be SJC, and it should be more precise and so that I can add more specific. So let me add some building 14. Along with I have that, that's what I've created. Let me just add this address just for a demo purpose. So let me just add it, paste it, so it automatically will take, because it's already in an integration with Google Maps and stuff. So latitude and longitude, so I'll just add it, so you can see that it's automatically pop up with building 14. So I want to be more precise now, so let me add a floor on that. So under the building, what floor I'm saying, so I'm saying floor 4. Yeah, so I'll just change here to 4. Add. So once that is done, you can see that, and you can add also if you have a floor plan also. We have a floor plan in our demo, so I'll just upload it and go to save this. So without even a wasting of time, the floor plan pops. So you can see how GUI is more easy for you to narrow down what location you are talking and what network device you are talking. That comes the overall design of a network hierarchy. So under the building 14 on floor 4, you have this plan, what location you are speaking, all these things you can have in a single pane of glass from DNAC, right? So now let's go into the second part, what we are going to say as an integration of Cisco ISE. So in order to do that, you first need to integrate the Cisco ISE with this particular DNAC, which you need to go on system settings. So under the system settings, when you enter into settings, and if you see on authentication and policy server, you have nothing here. So you add it. So I have the details of ISE, what I'm going to populate here. So let me just do that. Okay, copy. So this is my ISE, which is having this particular IP address. So I'll be using the shared secret as same Cisco. Capital C, to be very honest, so it would be more easy. As this is an ISE, so I'll just enable ISE. You can use anything, whatever it is having radius protocol and thing. And let me put a username admin and same password. So this password is the login password. Actually, you have to be very you need to be very cautious in order to have it's a case sensitive and all those things. So that's why I'm not typing it, I'm just trying to avoid delay. So just put the paste here. Okay, let me go here, let me confirm again. Yeah, so this would be the FQD in which you would have configured for ISE. So let me, that's a mandate stuff, so you need to add it. Should be the subscriber, which actually pops up the DNAC for sure. Yeah, I don't need for an SSH key and stuff. So let me just apply. Still, it's actually getting applied. Let's jump onto the Cisco ISE also in the meantime. So I'm already here. So you can see I've just applied the same IP address in my ISE, right? So we first go to an administration tab, and under that we need to go in setting and to see what all the things are there actually. So you don't need to worry, we will just go on ER setting first. So we just need to enable this. Enabling this, okay. So the ERS setting is required for read write access and all those things. So it has been configured, right? So under then we will go for an user creation mainly. What type of user it is going to come to us. So you need to create a user for this, like someone has created a selection. So we'll add another user. And we will map that user to one of the admin group. So I will take it as a user called ERS, oh sorry, E, to be very precise, ERS admin. And paste it, status enabled. Okay. And the password is, I've taken a standard Cisco 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Type it, paste, type, paste. And you need to map this user, which is already in integration with AD, so under the ERS admin group, just summary. Okay, so bingo. So you can see it's already been added under the ERS admin group. Okay, now on the system and the deployment, you have ISE, so I just need to add or enable certain parameters, because Cisco ISE used to talk with DNAC, with their PXC protocol. So an AP application has been done. So we need to enable certain things in order to do that. So we need to first enable SXP service along with passive identity and PXC server. That's all. So if you see this thing, you just need to do that. That's all. So this will take some time for an integration stuff. You have to refresh the thing. And this will take some time. So so in the meantime, let's see the status there. So it says active here in DNAC center. So we need to refresh ISE PXCrypt state, and all of a sudden you will get a DNAC subscriber here, and we need to approve that. So once that is done, so Cisco ISE integration happens with your DNACs. And all the groups and AD integration which are being, you know, part of Cisco ISE normally gets populated onto your DNAC. Then you create your policies and provision it. It will take some time actually, so do need to worry that, and don't worry that it's not happened, nothing like that. You will see it in a while, or it may take some time actually, a minute also at times. So we need to be patient. So don't worry about the things that if it is not coming, so just be patient. So I'm just, you know, just doing a refresh. So because ISE is one of the key component in overall DNAC framework for policy based segmentation, right? So yeah, still waiting and waiting. Just be patient. So once this is done, this is one of the major things for an automated policy system where the policy is based on the group or the SAT or the group policies, and which will help you as to, you know, define how to how to apply policies between the groups. So just be patient, so because I try to make it alive, so that's why it's taking an actual time. So just bear with the time, guys. So overall video actually compressed of this. I just want to show you sort of how the integration of ISE with DNAC and how to create a network hierarchy. And once that system setting has been done, then how the policies are getting inherited onto your network hierarchy groups. So which is also easy. You don't need to, you know, apply to all the areas. You just need to just accept yes. So I'll show that actually. I mean, that is the final part for this video. You know, kickstart or to showcase what is the advantage of the new era of networking, which is, I mean, more of a GUI and easy and simplest way. Super. See, patience. Patience is the key for success and automation. So you just need to select it and you have to approve it. Yeah, you do it. Super. So my patience actually, you know, yielded a fruitful result. So let me just jump back on the DNSC. So I'll go here again on the design part. So if you see, I don't have anything here, you know, in the network setting, the network hierarchy, right? So I'll just add a server here, the same, which is actually inherited now, and the same shared key. I don't want to take any chance. Let me just take this. So this was a shared key, which I have used it in that system configuration. Okay, so let me just add, just to cross verify. Super. So that's our case. And I have a DHCP server and DNS, everything is configured. Let me just add it and save. Got it? Yeah, successful. So what will happen if you click on this thing, right? So it will automatically ask, or it will inherit the things automatically. Normally it asks you to inherit like this, the pop-up comes, and if you say don't show again, so it will do. So you just need to say okay. So if it's done for floor, ask for building. So it's from, you know, child to parent, it actually goes. You need, once you click on those particular parent tabs, building 14 or SJC, so it will automatically inherit. So something which pops under those particular parents, it will inherit all these AAA settings automatically. See, that is the beauty of automation. Got it? So I would like to say, I mean, this is what I want to show on a quick live demo, how the DNS center looks like and how you configure the policies, and with an Cisco ISE integration, which was the main theme for this particular video. So I mean, that's all from point of view for this particular video. I would like to say that keep watching and subscribe the video for more talks, so that we can have lots of queries, and whatever queries you have, do add your comments on the videos, and stay tuned for other videos which are going to come more from a policy management, how the data flow happens in Cisco SDA world. Thank you very much for watching this, and have a nice day and time and weekend wherever you are. Thank you.